son of your own body to bring them to death. God is like, okay, you want to lust after the flesh, you want to be unclean, and you want to disobey me, I'm going to leave you to yourself. I'm going to let you do what you want to do. If you will be without excuse, on judgment day, you'll be without excuse. But God says, those that know my son shall have eternal life. But those that know not my son are already condemned. What does that mean to be already condemned? That means you're alive right now and you're dead man walking. It's like the prison guard in prison when he goes to the jail cell and he gets that guy that's slated for execution and they're walking into the execution chamber and he says to the guard, dead man walking! You're a dead man walking! Because you refuse Jesus. Amen? That's your final destination. But for right now, God says you are already condemned. Already condemned. You know how good our God is? He tells us ahead of time. He tells us ahead of time that we're already condemned if we don't follow Jesus. That's how much He loves us. Because if He wanted to do any harm to us, He wouldn't give us a warning. He wouldn't give us a warning. Amen. Amen. For God so loved the world that yet while we were still sinners, Jesus died for us. That is this gospel right here. In other words, this message is, come back to God, I'm not dying the world. Because if you're living in sin, Babylon! Babylon, amen? America's becoming Babylon! Sodom and Gomorrah, look what happened to Sodom and Gomorrah. Alrighty then, I'm going to let Sister Monet get on the mic. You ready, Sister Monet?
You going to face this or you going to face that? Okay.
I know a lot of y'all are upset.
How to stay within faith.
While we're out here, watching for us in the morning, you don't want us to hear. You got people walking across talking about the world Satan. And that just shows how many demons are within them. But because we love y'all, and God loves y'all, we're out here telling you how you can have a relationship with God. Because without Jesus Christ, you're always going to be separate from God. So yeah, you can see that we're being married, or to get lost, or you have a need to be doing something better with your life. No, I'm here on this earth to please God. That's the only reason I'm alive. Yeah, marriage is nice. Yeah, having a nice job is nice. Yeah, having money is nice. Yeah, having family is nice. But what does that matter if you do not have a relationship with Jesus Christ? Even the richest people on earth say they're still missing something, and it's because they do not have Jesus Christ. Everybody is searching for something until they find Jesus Christ. Even from my own experience, I was lost without Jesus Christ. I was searching, trying to fill that void, and I know a lot of y'all fill a void. With a blunt, or a drink, or with another person. But you know, stop worrying about looking for something other than Jesus Christ. It's always going to leave you. Everything in this world will leave you, except for Jesus Christ, because he says, I will never leave nor forsake you. So you have an option, you have a choice to either stay in this world and follow Satan, like a lot of people want to do, because the world makes you feel nice. Those people make you feel nice. But when you're by yourself, you don't feel so nice. You want to take your own life. I've been there. You want to take your own life. You feel like you don't want to live. Because what's the purpose of living if you have no purpose with Jesus Christ? Nothing in this world matters without Jesus Christ, the one that hung on that cross for you. Whether you choose to accept him or not, that's the love of Jesus Christ. He hung on that cross for everyone, so no one may be condemned. God doesn't want anyone to be condemned, but we all have a choice. Will I follow Jesus Christ, or will I follow Satan? You have a choice. Because that's the glory and the grace and the mercy of God that he gave us a choice. So freedom isn't being able to do what you want like the world tells you. Freedom isn't being able to do what you want like the world tells you. Because that's why we have a problem with abortion now. Because everyone doesn't want to follow God's rules. And it's not for God to be a dictator, it's for us to protect us. It's for him to protect us. Because he knew that we come from people, sleeping with people, that there's no one to give their bodies than their feelings and their emotions to. Why is it easier to give your body to somebody than give your emotions to them?
Does it feel good?
I bet it does feel good. This world feels good. I know it feels good because I was in the world. But God tells us to come out of the world. He tells us to come out of the world because he knows what the world has for us. And the world only wants death for us. So yes, it feels good. But it leads to death. Jesus says there's one path. There's a narrow path. There are only three and two, and there's a broad way, and I ain't talking about New York City. There's a broad way that Satan wants each and every one of us to go down. And not because he loves us, but because he hates God so much. He hates God so much, and the only way to hurt God is to give it to his people, to God's creation. Satan hasn't created anything to just disturb it. So now people say, oh, God created me. But now you think there's healing in the past instead of healing in the Savior Jesus Christ that wants to take away your anxiety, that wants to take away your depression, that wants to take away your hurt. You're never going to be able to find that in anything else, in anyone else. The solution is Jesus Christ. But again, you have a choice. Because of the God of the universe, and not the universe that people want to serve, who they want to serve. People would rather serve creation than serve the creator and things that God makes. There's a God that created everything that you want to serve, but still you refuse to serve the creation instead of the creator. That doesn't make sense. Follow the creator instead of the creation, and you have peace, you have joy, you have everlasting life. Through Jesus Christ, who hung on the cross for you, for me, for everyone, even though they didn't want to accept him. And let me tell you, the thing about being a Christian If we are not in our place yet, we're not better than you, we just feel like we need help. And only our help can come from Jesus Christ. Because God is perfect, we stand up for trials and tribulations, but through His goodness, He has overcome the world. The world. By hanging on that cross and being raised again, resurrected on the third day, He defeated death, so that our death, He and the Son of Him can have eternal life. And the thing about that is, even if we die now, if we know deep down in our hearts that we are not wrong, Jesus promised we are not wrong if we follow Him. But even if we die, what do we have to lose? The people that choose not to follow Him, we have all these things to lose, because what if we are right? We are right. And you have all the things to lose if you don't choose to follow Him. But by me following Him, what do I gain? Peace? Joy? A father that I couldn't, an earthly father that I didn't have. Now I have a heavenly Father that loves me more than anything I had, any man has a place. I had everything to gain with Jesus Christ. I had no life without Jesus Christ. I was headed to hell on a grease pole. And so I knew if you don't choose to follow Jesus Christ, it's an option that you're to make. But you cannot be mad at God when you spend eternity in hell with Satan. You cannot be mad at God because He gave you an option. Follow me, follow God, or be apart from me. And you know, depression, anxiety, pain of this world does not compare to God lifting His hand from your life. That's the worst feeling ever. That is the worst feeling ever, because even when I was walking, when I felt alone, God was still with me. I didn't know He was with me, but He was still with me, walking with me during my pain. And God wants to walk with each and every one of you through your pain. Just because you're Christian doesn't mean you're not going to feel pain, because you're probably going to feel more pain, because now the world hates you, because you're speaking truth. Jesus said He is the way, the truth, and the life. So that means He is the only way. So people may say, there's a lot of ways to God, but Jesus said He's the only way, the only way. The only truth, there's only one truth. Everybody wants to say that it is not truth. No, somebody has to be wrong. Sorry, not sorry. Somebody has to be wrong. And I know my Savior, Jesus Christ, will hold on the cross for me, that lives for me, for each of my sins, for all of my iniquities, for all of my hurt, for all of my pain, for all of my anxiety, for all of my depression. I know He's not wrong. I know He's not wrong. I know my Savior's not wrong. He wants to be the Lord and Savior of your life. He wants to be the Lord and Savior of your life. My heart can't be touched with your iniquity. You can find His power. Jesus, you cannot find His power. You know why? Because He's sitting on the right hand of the Father. We are interceding for each and every one of us. My Savior is still alive. Amen. None of these other deities, these other gods of the Lord can see, can be touched with the feelings of your iniquity. You're tired of the pain. You're tired of the pain.